Clinical neuroscience is something where we have this marriage between research at the bench and what happens at the bedside.
We want to have impactful research. There are clinical questions that need to be answered, and with clinical neuroscience, we want to be able to take these research questions to the lab, be able to answer the questions and take them back to the patient. And I think this is the forefront of change for our patients.
The range of neurological diseases is just enormous. You know, our textbooks are kind of volumes thick, and there are very few of them where we totally understand the cause, and even fewer of them where we've got a treatment.
There are currently no treatments for most of these neurological diseases. So a better understanding of how to diagnose them and how to treat them is one of the most challenging questions of our time.
You know, even beyond the people who die from severe strokes, there are hundreds of thousands of Australians who live with disability from stroke, and we need to find new ways to reduce that burden.
I hope that the impact of my research and that of my greater group here at Perinatal Research Centre is that we can improve the quality of life for babies that have had a traumatic injury to the world.
Currently, there's no known treatment for Parkinson's. There isn't a cause known for it either. So current treatments can only manage the symptoms of Parkinson's. We hope to discover new treatments for the disease, new biomarkers to identify it earlier, and also translate these treatments from the lab to the clinic. And that was my rationale for moving here to CCR, because we're so close to the hospital. And we can work with neurologists and directly translate our discoveries here in the lab to the hospital next door.
In the acute field, research has already revolutionised acute treatment, and we've dramatically changed the outcomes of people in the acute phase from stroke. And that's all been driven by research and large clinical trials, many of which have been led in Australia. We'll start by getting a new understanding of what's really going on in the brain after injury, and then we'll use that to develop new treatments that we can test in clinical trials.
It's clear as we enter the genomic era that genetics plays a major role in epilepsy. It's now to understand the specific genetic cause for a particular patient.
And one of the wonderful factors about clinical neuroscience is that we can collaborate with a number of different groups, and together we're coming up with that solution to improve patient lives.
We're in a time where we have more ideas than we've ever had about how to support the recovery of the injured brain.
It's quite optimistic at the moment in the field of neuroscience. There's a real sense, even in terrible diseases like motor neurone disease, that we're just about to crack it.
Hopefully the future looks good. I think we're in the generation of big data as well, and that allows us to really dig a lot deeper with our research into what's going wrong in these brains. And if we can get much more information about what's going wrong, we're armed with a lot greater information about how we can make that right.